Somebody kiss me. Somebody's got a hug. Somebody's got to pull me out from under this rug.
Well, my name's Thomas Cook, and I'm the proud father of Elizabeth Cook, and I met her mother when I got out of the chain gang for running moonshine, and first knew you know we got married, and 9 months later, here come Elizabeth.
I was 41, and he was 46, and we got married, and the next thing you know, I was pregnant, and with my sixth child, and Elizabeth, that's how Elizabeth came into the world. She's a miracle child, I tell her. One day, when she was about 4 years old, I heard her out in the yard, and she was swinging on her swing set out there, just singing away.
We met in a recording studio, didn't we?
Yes.
And
you were on a session.
I was playing guitar on a Hardy McGee session with a famous country singer.
Songwriter.
Oh yeah, that's right. And she was there because she wrote for that same publishing company. For 2 seconds, met her, you know, somebody. But this is Elizabeth. Jeff joked, he said, this is Elizabeth. She got your publishing deal. Because I had been talking to them about a publishing deal, and then I got some other opportunities.
He turned them down.
And so she got that spot. And then, anyway, I met her that day, and I was like, well, dang, they did okay. You know, and then. If you ever want to take a ride on the fastest train alive,
Delta, just on a little trip, just the two of us just driving through the Delta, and we got into Oxford, and there was a courthouse there, and Tim said, let's just go up in the courthouse, and I was like in sweat clothes, and my hair was wet, and I was like, uh-uh, then we ain't doing it. I said, as soon as we get home, I'll figure out something. So I got on the internet as soon as I got home, and started looking for places, and made a little plan, and we ended up just going down to Key Largo. I hired this lady that baked a cake and put together some flowers for me, and we got him a suit, and I found a dress, and I got a good little photographer. We went down there and got married. And
anyway, it just turned out that Tim has been a real asset to her and her music, and it's amazing to wonder to see him take charge in rehearsals of bands, especially when they have new members coming in. He takes charge of her music and just tells them guys what to play and all. She don't have to worry about that.
It's 13, Dave. $9.98.
All right.
That's Opry-esque. I work at a place called Jamie. It's like a one-of-a-kind only department store on West End, okay. And I just go in and help them out with their computers and books and sell whatever they need when I'm in town. Okay. But they have like Gucci and Prada and Dolce & Gabbana, so I get a discount.
What I love about Elizabeth Cook is she has a wonderful voice. She's a very gifted songwriter and a very compelling entertainer. All eyes seem to focus on Elizabeth when she's on the Grand Ole Opry stage.
Well, good evening, everybody, and welcome to the green room here at the Grand Ole Opry House. This is the Grand Ole Opry warm-up show. Get ready for the big Saturday night show here in Texas.
Truly down-to-earth country entertainer and traditional country music she does, and we love her and respect her for that. You're going to enjoy her, Miss Elizabeth Cook. Give her a nice round of applause. Yes, she is.
Yeah, I think I've sacrificed some things, but anything worth having is worth that. I gave up a lifestyle of being an accountant and having a retirement fund and having health insurance and always having a car that works and having a structure to my life. And I gave that up, but in return I get a lot. I get to go out on stage and interact with people and give people a good time, and they give me a good time, and I get to play music with my husband, and I get to write. And so what are those things worth? I never thought that I'd get to meet Loretta Lynn or have a conversation with Dolly Parton.
Country music at its best is all about real people singing real songs about real life, and Elizabeth Cook has a very unique but at the same time real perspective.
My biggest challenge ahead professionally is probably just keeping it all afloat and selling for bluer waters. You know, there's out looking for the next deal. Things are forming and things are shaping up, but I can't predict what it's going to be. I don't know where I'm going to be in a year. I might be way better off, I might be worse off. I don't know.
Elizabeth Cook, Little Brother, standing out on the plaza.